Hello, people. I'm Jabby Kuwait, joined by Carolina Sofia. And we're looking at Tony Kakar's Canta Laga is the greatest song ever. Dinchak Puja is better from Triggered Insan. Now, to give you some context, Dinchak Puja is probably unanimously known in India as the worst pop artist of all time. She put out this music video that made her famous for being awful. Like, just downright awful. She can't carry a beat, she can't carry a tune. And then she tried to capitalize on that by deliberately making a bad music video, which not as many people paid attention to.
It's kind of a smart move, though, if you think about it. I wish I'd thought of that.
He's saying, Tony Kakar's Canta Laga is the greatest song ever. Dinchak Puja is better. I don't know what that means. Thank you, Triggered Insan, for allowing us to react to this. Very, very much appreciate it. Y'all, if you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button, bell icon, all notifications, and vote this video up to let YouTube know you're enjoying what you're watching. Here we go.
आपको याद होगा वो वक्त जब भारत देश पर कुछ काली शक्तियों ने अपना वर्चस्व स्थापित कर लिया था. चारों ओर हाहाकार मचा हुआ था. इंसान तड़प रहे थे और इन सब के कारण वह एक ढिंचक पूजा जिसने कभी तो सेल्फी मैंने ले ली आज, कभी दारू दारू दारू, कभी बापू दे दे थोड़ा कैश, कभी दिलों का स्कूटर है मेरा शूटर, और ना जाने ऐसे कितने क्रिंज गाने बना बना के सोशल मीडिया का निरंतर शोषण किया. लेकिन जब धरती ढिंचक पूजा के खौफ से जूझ रही थी, एक दूसरा बलवान जन्म ले चुका था.
He's making this so epic by he's using footage from a movie called Bahubali. At least that last shot was Bahubali. I think the previous one was from a film called KGF. I think that's the one, because the clips look like they were pulled from KGF. You guys can correct me in the comments if you want. But they're like very epic action movies. Talking about Dinchak Puja with that is
and the music in the background.
Yeah, it's just very,
great.
Very clever.
वो जो इस सदी का सबसे महान गीतकार कहलाया जाएगा, वो जिसके गाने लोग अपने अलार्म की तरह यूज करेंगे ताकि अलार्म बजने से एक घंटा पहले उठ के अलार्म बंद कर सके ताकि उनको वो अलार्म ना सुनना पड़े, वो जिसके गाने कॉन्स्टिपेशन के इलाज के लिए यूज किए जाएंगे, वो जिसके क्रिंज के सामने ढिंचक पूजा का क्रिंज भी इतू सा लगता है, वो
Okay, first off, if I heard a terrible song, I don't think it would cure my constipation. I think it would tighten it up. It would tighten your sphincter. Like, oh, what the hell is that? What am I hearing? I don't think it would make you release. I don't think it would assist with the bowel of movements, the movement of bowels. I think it would restrict the flow of internal data.
I have never given my bowel movements this much thought.
You should. Every day, every day. I heard women talk about it more than guys do. Okay, here we go.
पड़ा भाई फड़फड़ा वाले अंकल की बात नहीं कर रहा, मैं बात कर रहा हूँ उस महान गीतकार की जिसने हमें
सावन भी कितने तुझ बिन बरसे हैं
और
मुझे ना और रुलाना तू सावन आया
जैसे कमाल कमाल के गीत दिए हैं. लेकिन बैटमैन मूवी में एक बहुत ही पॉपुलर कहावत है,
you either die a hero or you live long enough to see yourself become the villain.
और इस महान वाक्य को सच करते हुए हमारे प्यारे
टोनी कक्कर
Born in 1984, Tony Kakkar. Come on, Tony, you can do it. Pave the way, put your back into it. Tell us why, show us how. Look at where you came from.
Look at you now.
Oh, you saw that? you saw what's his name's comedy special? Can't remember his name all of a sudden. But that's from a comedy special on Netflix.
I've just seen the Jeffrey Bezos.
Yeah, that one. He's sang the Jeffrey Bezos song.
Yeah.
Why can't I remember his name? Bo Burnham.
Oh, I love Bo Burnham.
Yeah, Bo Burnham's the one who did the song. So that's what he's making fun of just now. Or he was lovingly using it as an homage to Bo Burnham.
Look at where you came from, look at you now. As if हमें लॉकडाउन में क्रिंज की कमी पड़ रही थी कि क्रिंज की देवी ढिंचक पूजा एंड हमारे फेवरेट टोनी भैया दोनों ने एक ही हफ्ते में अपने अपने एटम न्यूक्लियर बॉम्ब गाने निकाल दिए हैं.
बंद करो.
लेकिन आप लोगों को तो पता ही है, जब जब क्रिंज बढ़ेगा अपन को तो आना पड़ेगा, व्यूज के लिए आना पड़ेगा,
मेरे को जाना पड़ेगा.
I don't think he's as bad as her.
I don't think so either. And this looks like quality production, at least.
Hello, my name is Tommy Kurkure.
मेरा जन्म ना एक्चुअली बचपन में ही
हुआ और माँ
मेरी लेडी थी
मैं पैदा हुआ ना मेरे पैदा होते मेरे पापा ने
मेरा बेटा
सिंगर
बनेगा
बस फिर क्या था वहां से शुरू हो गई मेरी सिंगर बनने की जर्नी सारे अब तुम गाओ
What? The Harry Potter music?
Sa, 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 sa.
अरे टोमी बेटा रे गा मा पा धा नी सा कहाँ गया
वो मैं मस्त तेल में फ्राई करके वो मैं खा गया
जब सा से काम चल सकता है तो रे गा मा पा धा नी सा की क्या जरूरत है सा 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 आप लोग ही बताओ यार जब सा से काम चल सकता है तो बाकी रे गा मा पा की क्या जरूरत है स्कूल में भी टीचर बोली
ए फॉर एप्पल
ए फॉर एप्पल
बी फॉर बॉय
B for apple.
I thought it was going to say A for
C
apple
for
again.
Cat.
C for apple.
C for apple. A for apple. B for B apple. C for B apple. D for B apple. E for B apple. Apple.
His
apple.
His mom's laughing. I love that his mom can't keep it straight.
मैं अपने गानों में same lyrics बार 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 repeat करता रहता हूँ. अरे एक बात बताओ. मैंने गाना लिखा कुड़ी तू chocolate है लेड है लेड है.
लेड मेरी कपी केक है केक है.
आए ना 1 billion views. अरे तो आगे क्यों बढ़ू मैं ऊपर से तुम लोग कहते हो भाई तेरे को लिरिक्स नहीं लिखने आते तुम्हें पता है लिरिक्स लिखना कितना मुश्किल है You're the champ. Who's the champ? You're the champ. Who's the best singer? You're the best singer. Who's the best lyrics writer? I'm the best lyrics writer. Yes, I can do it. Come, Willie, आंटी 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 एक मिनट जरा बर्तन खड़काना बंद करो मैं लिरिक्स लिख रहा हूँ पानी 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 बहुत तेज है पंखा आ रही है तेज पानी आ जाएगी मेरी नानी पानी 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 इतना सारा लिरिक्स भी आज के लिए बहुत है कभी कभी तो लगता है अपुनिच अरिजीत इमरान कामिल और लिरिक्स राइटर कौन है जावेद जाफरी जावेद अख्तर सब अपुनी है
अच्छा एक बार मुझे फैन फेस्ट में बुला लिया था लाइव गाने के लिए मेरा मैनेजर बोला अच्छी अपॉर्चुनिटी है तो मैं चला गया मुझे क्या पता था लाइव शो में ऑटो ट्यून नहीं होता ऑटो ट्यून के बिना भी मैंने बहुत अच्छा गाया था यार दीदी तो मेरा गाना सुन के रो भी पड़ी थी पर ऑडियंस को पसंद ही नहीं आया
आज जाके चेक कर लो यूट्यूब पे उस फैन फेस्ट की सबकी परफॉर्मेंसेस मिल जाएगी सिवाय मेरे ये थोड़ी ना कह रहा हूँ कि मैंने हटवाई है
समझ रहे हो
तुम्हें पता है मुझे नोबेल प्राइज मिला है फॉर माय कंट्रीब्यूशन टू मेडिकल साइंस मेरे गाने सुनने के बाद कोमा में बड़े पेशेंट्स खुद खड़े होके स्पीकर बंद कर रहे हैं और लोग कहते हैं मेरे गाने बेकार हैं तुम लोग यूट्यूब पे ये नल्ले रोस्टर्स बनाते रहो मेरे ऊपर वीडियो पर मेरे गानों को 1 billion व्यूज भी देते रहो मेरे को क्या फर्क पड़ रहा है मैं बनाता रहूंगा जिससे याद आया मेरा नया गाना आया है दीदी और हनी पाजी के साथ कांटा लगा उई मा उई मा
उई मा उई मा उई मा कांटा लगा उई मा उई मा उई मा
उई मा उई मा कैसा है गाना बता भाई कैमरामैन बढ़िया है ना
All right, well, okay. Here's the thing. Lyrics in this day and age can be quite nonsensical and it'll still work as long as the beat is good.
Yeah.
And so even if the person is saying the same thing over and over again, first and foremost, whatever you enjoy, you enjoy. I might judge you, but you shouldn't feel shame for enjoying what you enjoy. And I say that because I was about to say, like, I don't judge anyone, but I totally judge people. I judge people all the time for the music that they like. And I just keep it inside. Well, unless your name's Achara Kirk, I just keep it inside. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, I feel like a lot of music is made from a corporate machine of some kind, and it's just, like, mm-hmm. just churning this shit out. The thing is, what matters at the end of the day is just a good beat to dance to.
Mm-hmm.
More than anything. We're not trying to create art in terms of sophisticated lyrics.
Mm-hmm.
We're just trying to create a dance beat. That's all people are looking for. They don't really care about what you're trying to say. If you listen to the song Pumped Up Kicks, it's just a good beat.
And then you listen to what they're saying.
You listen to what they're saying, and they're talking about Columbine. Right? And it's crazy. Like, you wouldn't have known that. Most people who hear that song don't give a shit that it's about Columbine. They just like the sound of it.
I'm literally like...
yeah. And so here, I'm listening to it. I'm just getting a fraction of it. And he can only play a fraction of the song because otherwise I'll get a copyright issue, right? What he's playing of it, I'm not hating.
I don't hate it.
I'm not hating it because I can only hear a part of it, but if you just extrapolate from those few seconds that that's the same sound through the whole song, mm-hmm. you can see how that gets monotonous after a while and quite aggravating. Because I haven't heard these songs outside of this video. First and foremost, like, you like what you like. People like what they like. Why get mad about it?
And also, you can like both. You can like a really beautifully written song that you want to cry to at home by yourself, but when you want to go to the club, maybe you just want to listen to a beat say the same thing over and over.
I personally would rather that than a lot of the heinous vulgar lyrics that we get in a lot of our songs over here.
True.
Personally, I'd rather you just sing the same shit. Like the tra-la-la guy just said tra-la-la for the entire 3-minute song, and people love the shit out of that. You know what song I'm talking about? The Russian dude?
No.
I think it's tra-la-la. Let me see if I can. You don't know this meme? He died a while back, but like it was an awesome song. Tra-la-la-la. This guy. I can't play the whole thing, obviously.
Is it like the tra-la-la-la-la-la-la?
Yeah, that guy.
Yeah. yeah, I do know.
He's saying the same shit over and over again. And the story behind this one, real quick, the quick rundown is, he had lyrics to the song, but because of where he was being so intensely conservative, he had to keep stripping it of lyrics until all he had were sounds. But if you know the original intent of the song and you watch this music video, it makes so much sense. That's what's weird. And so I'd rather just random noises and shit than have shitty vulgar lyrics. If you can't come up with something creative, might as well throw out all the creativity and just make the same sound over and over again.
I have a genius idea. What if we make a song together?
You wanna do that?
We should. Let's monetize on this.
Okay.
One word.
I don't know how to stay in key at all, but okay. We can auto-tune my ass.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know how to sing either.
Yeah, okay, so we'll just be the auto-tune duo.
Comment what word you think we should use.
Cameraman.
God damn. Okay, see, that's objectively bad. Like, you can hear even through the fraction of this, it not being our language, you can just hear that that's pretty awful.
You're being a hater.
No, that's objectively bad.
Yeah.
I am not musically inclined whatsoever. I'm terrible at singing, but objectively speaking, that's bad. Not that I'd be any better. I'd probably be just as bad, so. It's not even trying.
वाह 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 डिन चेक दीदी पहले तो आपको congratulations पिछले वाले वीडियो में आप गाड़ी में थी गाड़ी मेरी
टू सीटर I can't with the glasses
इस बार प्लेन तक पहुंच गई है तो तरक्की हो गई है और एक ही बीट पे आपने दोनों गाने बना दिए हैं
I think that she actually was trying. See, I give her more credit for the car song because I think she was genuinely trying to do a good song in the first one. And so I give it more of a pass than the airplane one. In the airplane one, she was going out of her way to be bad. Do you know what I mean? Like, there's a big difference between
that.
The two. There's a guy named Tommy Wiseau who made a movie called The Room. It's just like, you known in the States as the worst movie of all time. That is the Dinchak Puja of American films, okay? But he had a lot of heart when he made that movie. You can feel it when you watch it. Like, he really tried to make a good movie. It was just awful.
Poor guy.
Right? But then he made a movie called Best Friends, and that's how I ended up meeting one of my best friends, Kristen Stephens-Impino, who was the main actress. It's a two-part film. She was the main actress in those films. And so I got invited to the screening. That's how I met her. Super, super awesome girl. You'd love her. But anyway, the movies are not good movies, and she knows this. My point being is Tommy Wiseau and Greg Sestero tried to make a bad movie. There's a big difference between trying to do a good job and it's awful.
No, I understand what you're saying.
And then deliberately doing a bad job. Yeah. It doesn't have the same charm.
Yeah.
So her airplane song doesn't have the same charm, is all I'm trying to say. That's the long winded version of what I'm
पिछले गाने की भी बीट सेम इस गाने की भी बीट सेम एक्चुअली पिछले 15 गानों की बीट सेम टू सेम है वही एक ही सेम बीट चलती रहती है उसी पे ही लिरिक्स अलग अलग चेंज होते रहते हैं बट जाऊं मैं प्लेन में रहूं फ्रंट लेन में पैसा मेरी जेब में हिटर सारे जेल में
ढिंचक दीदी
आपके लिरिक्स आर डेफिनेटली मच मच बेटर देन टोनी भैया आई नो ये सुनने के बाद आप इसे बहुत सारे लोग बोलेंगे क्या बोल रहे पागल हो गया बट सीरियसली ढिंचक दीदी के गानों में एटलीस्ट लिरिक्स का मतलब तो बन रहा है कुछ
बैठू फर्स्ट क्लास में डॉलर भी है पास में रोलेक्स मेरे हाथ में जीसस मेरे साथ में
भाई मैं मजाक नहीं कर रहा ये ढिंचक पूजा इतने लिरिक्स कहां से ला रही है बैठू फर्स्ट क्लास में रोलेक्स मेरे हाथ में जीसस मेरे साथ में इतने लिरिक्स टोनी भैया ने अपने पिछले 30 गानों में नहीं लिखे जितने इसने अपने गाने के 30 सेकंड में लिख दिए क्या चल रहा है
पीछे 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 तेरे तेरे बगीचे नीचे नीचे
Okay, you guys gotta understand, Carolina and I live in Los Angeles. There is certain ethnic music, shall we say, that is highly, intensely, relentlessly repetitive. And it's just the same beat, and this particular group plays this music loud so the whole neighborhood could hear it with extra, extra bass. And it's frustrating as fuck, to say the least. But hey, you know, you just accept. And so compared to that, like—
Are you referring to Latinos?
I'm referring to Mexican music. But the music I'm thinking of is just like the same sound over and over and over and over again.
Dun, ka, dun, ka, dun.
Yeah.
That's reggaeton, that's Puerto Rican. Hater.
You need to leave. That shit is terrible. It's not Puerto Rican. I only hear Mexicans playing this shit. But all of, I mean, you're the only Puerto Rican I actually hang around.
Yeah.
But all I'm saying is, like, I hear that and I'm like, okay, so how long is that going to go on for? And it goes on all night long. It's the same beat for 4 hours. So compared to that, okay, this is very bearable. This is very, very doable. I can deal with this. Albeit, we're only listening to it for like
30 seconds at a time.
30 seconds at a time. I was getting Carolina to say things in Hindi. I was wondering if you could say, Baglikia.
No, I'm not doing this again.
You're not saying any bad words.
What am I saying?
You're saying, are you stupid?
Are you crazy?
Are you crazy?
Say it again.
Because he said it and it made me think of you. Baglikia.
Baglikia.
But you got to say with like...
Baglikia. Close?
No.
Baglikia.
No, that's close. But you got to say it with emphasis.
Baglikia.
But like at
Baglikia.
One more time.
Baglikia.
That actually,
I did great, you guys.
That actually goes together. They're like, ah.
Just let me appreciate the language and don't make fun of me as I try to learn. I thought I could trust you.
First class mein, Rolex mere haath mein, Jesus mere saath mein. Itne lyrics Tony bhaiya ne apne pichle 30 gaanon mein nahi likhe, jitne isne apne gaane ke 30 second mein likh diye hain. Kya chal raha hai?
हां जी, तो सबसे पहले तो हम इस गाने के डिस्क्रिप्शन में जाके चेक करेंगे कि लिरिक्स किसने लिखे हैं। वैसे तो इस गाने में कोई लिरिक्स है नहीं, फिर भी एक बार चेक कर लेते हैं। एंड ओहो, हमें तो जैसे पता ही नहीं था कि इस गाने को गाया है टोनी भैया ने, लिरिक्स लिखे हैं टोनी भैया ने, म्यूजिक भी है टोनी भैया का। अरे टोनी भैया, ठीक है मोदी जी बोले थे कि आत्मनिर्भर बनिए, लेकिन इतना भी नहीं कि भाई तुम सबके काम भी खुद ही करना शुरू कर दो और अल्टीमेटली ऐसा हग दो। लिरिक्स है, राजा तेरे महल के पीछे 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 पीछे, तेरे बगीचे नीचे 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 नीचे, क्यों? क्योंकि काटता लगा उइमा उइमा उ। भाई सेंस का है इस बात में,
मतलब कुछ भी।
एक जमाना होता था जब गाने में ऐसा ना स्टोरी सुनाया करते थे,
आओ बच्चों तुम्हें दिखाएं झांकी हिंदुस्तान की, इस मिट्टी से तिलक करो ये धरती है बलिदान की।
आज बगीचे के साथ नीचे मैच कर रहे हैं और आगे काटा लगा उइमा उ करना है, तो एक बेफालतू का क्यों घुसा देते हैं, तो क्यों के साथ ऊ मैच हो जाएगा। ऊ आ ऊ आ, ऐसी बात है ना, टोनी कक्कड़ लिरिक्स लिख सकता है तो मैं भी लिख सकता हूँ। देखो,
here we go।
वाहियत से गाने गाता है वो, नाम है टोनी कक्कड़, दीवार पे चलता है, जाले बुनता है एक मकड़, क्यों? काटा लगा उइमा उइमा उ। बढ़िया भाई, मैं भी लिरिक्स राइटर
हूँ। You gotta commit, dude.
1 million views.
You gotta commit.
नीचे 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 काटा लगा उइमा उइमा,
काट डालूंगा।
Look, okay, the music might not be anything to write home about, but dude's got swag. I mean,
I like the outfit.
Yeah, he's got swag, but I mean, that's...
It's a vibe.
It's a vibe, you know? I wouldn't listen to it, but he's got swag going on, and that counts for something, right? I mean, he's got 1 billion views.
Yeah.
So people like to look at him.
Kaat dalunga. Are jaa, aisi dhamkiyon se darne
wale hum nahi.
Usse dosti kar le.
That's his dad.
I love the dad.
मारने के लिए गोली नहीं, टोनी कक्कड़ ही बहुत है।
I don't hate this at all.
It's just the same sound over and over again.
भाई टोनी भैया आप मेरी बात सुनो, जब तुम्हारे पास है ही नहीं कुछ लिखने को और अपने पुराने गानों के लिरिक्स तुम अपने नए गानों में रीयूज रिसाइकल कर रहे हो, वो भी तब जब तुम्हारा पूरा गाना बस एक ही शब्द होता है,
तो रहने दो ना, गाने क्यों बनाने जरूरी है। एक पिछले गाने में भी तुम्हारी लाइन थी।
Look, thing about it is, whether it's one word or 10,000 words, they're his lyrics and he wrote them. They may not be good. And it may not be quality, it may not be up to any remarkable standards, but they're his lyrics. Try dealing with mumble rap. You can't even hear what they're saying. At least with him, he's committing to the fact that he only knows one word.
Yeah, you know? He's owning it.
He's owning it. Whereas with mumble rap, it's like they're pretending that they are saying something, but it's all mumbled. You can't hear shit.
I think
on.
This guy is entertaining, but yeah. Don't come for me.
Yeah, don't at me in the comments.
Don't at me in the comments, please.
खाली खाली स्ट्रीट पे प्यार मोहब्बत करेंगे बेबी करेंगे बर्बाद।
अरे ये तो दूसरा गाना है।
उस गाने में भी पिछले गाने के किसी के लिरिक्स यूज किए हुए थे, इस गाने में भी धीमे 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 धीमे।
Hey, you got something working, you just keep making it work, you keep using it.
आइए गाइस, इस गाने का आपको ऑफिशियल वर्ड काउंट बताता हूँ मैं। उइमा 86 टाइम्स, नीचे और पीछे 6 बार ईच, आए 14 बार।
You have to appreciate the dedication to counting it though.
12 बार, उई 8 बार, आहा 4 बार और ये पूरा गाना बन गया। That's it. इसके अलावा कोई वर्ड है ही नहीं इस गाने में। उइमा उइमा, नीचे पीछे, आए धीमे धीमे, आ उ ई, रैंडम आवाजें जो मुंह से निकल रही है सब डाल दिया इसके अंदर। और 86 टाइम्स उइमा, 86 टाइम्स। कितनी देर लगती होगी ऐसे लिरिक्स लिखने में? 5 मिनट, 10 मिनट, 15 मिनट ले लो भाई टोनी भैया, अपना वक्त ले लो, हफ्ता महीना साल ले लो, आ जाएंगे उतने व्यूज। ये है हगू 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 हगू, इसका बच्चा जगू 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 जगू, इनका बच्चा भगू 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 भगू, लिख दिया गाना, लिख दिया।
I thought that was a hit song.
What he was doing?
Yeah.
Here's the thing, if it ain't broke, no one's gonna fix it. It's that simple. People only make adjustments if they need to in order to continue to make money. That's the only time. Unless you're someone like myself. Who will continue to make adjustments just for themselves. But like, there's a lot of businesses, a lot of business models out there. If they don't have to fix it, they won't. Adobe Premiere still fucking crashes on me.
Oh my God.
And people keep paying for it. It's like, okay, well, we
That's a great example.
You know, we can keep selling them this broken
app. What
are
you doing, Adobe?
Exactly.
You are so right.
Yeah.
Should we all cancel Adobe? Yeah. God, what am I paying for?
Exactly.
What am I paying for?
They'll
that just made me mad. I was having a good time. Now I'm triggered.
I don't even want to comment on Neha ji ke kapde pe yahan pe, jo ek bahut acha meme maine kahin padha tha. Wanted to be Cardi B, ban gayi Nibbi.
What? Nibbi?
हनी पाजी के रैप के अलावा इस गाने में एक भी अच्छी चीज नहीं है। दिस इज डेफिनेटली द वर्स्ट सॉन्ग जो टोनी भैया ने आज तक बनाया है, एंड मैं ये लिख के कह सकता हूँ, मतलब ढिंचक पूजा का गाना इससे बेटर है, इससे ज्यादा बड़ी चीज क्या हो सकती है।
घर मेरा पेरिस में, ऑफिस मेरा टैरिस पे, पार्टी कर क्रूज में, पीयू से जूस में।
लवर और हेटर ढिंचक पूजा के गानों की एक बात तो है कि अगली को जो दिखता है ना वो इसके गाने में होता है, मतलब एटलीस्ट लिरिक्स तो लिख रही है ना, अनलाइक सम अदर पीपल, जैसे एक हाथ में फोन है, दूसरे हाथ में रिमोट है, तीसरे हाथ में भी रिमोट है, तीसरा तो हाथ ही नहीं है। ओ यू गेट इट, ये हैरी पॉटर है, ये रोनाल्डो है, ये है, ये है, जो दिख रहा है वो गाने में जा रहा है। वेरी रिलेटेबल शीज, यू नो।
लिमोजिन कार में, डिनर 7 स्टार में, ढिंचक मेरे नाम में, स्वैग मेरे काम में।
समाओ दिस नॉनसेंस बुलशिट गाना, ये मुझे पसंद आया।
घर मेरा पेरिस में, ऑफिस मेरा टैरिस पे, पार्टी कर क्रूज में, पीयू से जूस में।
मुझे ढिंचक पूजा ने पैसे नहीं दिया ये बोलने के लिए, बट ये टोनी भैया के गाने के सामने तो इतना अच्छा लगा मुझे, क्या बताऊं मैं तुम्हें।
जाऊं मैं प्लेन में, प्लेन में, प्लेन में।
एनीवेज गाइस, आई होप यू गाइस एंजॉयड दिस वीडियो। दो कमाल कमाल के गाने आज मैंने आप लोगों को सुनाया है यहाँ पे, एंड विच सॉन्ग डू यू थिंक इज बेटर, डू कमेंट बिलो एंड वीडियो को लाइक कर देना। आई विल सी यू गाइस इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो, तब तक के लिए थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग।
This is called a false dichotomy. There is no need to put these two songs side by side. There just isn't. Like, why do that? It doesn't elevate the other one. Saying how bad Tony Kakkar is doesn't make Dinchuk Pooja better. They're bad for different reasons.
Yeah.
Dinchuk Pooja is bad because she can't carry a tune, much like myself. Tony Kakkar is bad because he can't write lyrics, unlike me. I can totally write lyrics.
Okay, let's see what you got.
I'm not gonna do it on the spot. No, not freestyle. Like, I would actually write. He's not freestyling. He's writing.
I want to see some lyrics.
He's writing
out
his lyrics.
I know you got him.
Not on me.
Mm-hmm.
I'll have to email you.
He's shy.
I'll send you an Instagram DM. I'll slide in to your DMs with some lyrics.
I don't hate the first guy. Sure, I would have to listen to more of it to know how annoying it really is, because this guy feels very passionately about it. So maybe it is.
You're talking about Triggered and Son?
Yeah. So yeah. Maybe it is that bad. But from what I saw, I didn't think it was the worst thing I've ever seen.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like we get worse stuff over here.
Yeah.
Honestly. Not only is worse, but is popular. Mm-hmm. And is playing in clubs.
Yeah.
Not only that, but gets a lot of plays. And so I'm like, all right, yeah, let's see.
You're right.
Moving on. I will say this, though. I enjoyed Triggered and Son's take on all of this. And I
Me
enjoyed
too.
His commentary. I enjoyed him going after it and putting his opinions out there and being like, look, this is bad. And being willing to also be attacked, because that's usually the first thing that happens.
Mm-hmm.
You attack something, someone's going to attack you back.
Mm-hmm. I was just going to say that. That's kind of brave, especially nowadays. Taking a stance on something and critiquing it.
He did a really good job of making his point, even though I disagree with him, fundamentally disagree with him, because I think it's a false dichotomy. I think that it's awesome that he like really took the time to like structure his ideas and go, look, this is exactly why I'm saying this. This one is clearly the better, even though you think it's awful. It's better than this over here, which is getting way more radio play. I'm like, all right, I hear you. I disagree, but I hear you. From what he was sampling, I would rather listen to Tony Kakkar than Dinchuk Buja.
100%.
But I wouldn't listen to either one if there was a third option, if there was a third door of like just GTFO, that's what I would go with.
I think I'm going to give my guy a chance. I'm going to go home and listen to a full song, and then I'll let you know how I feel.
I'm going to be saying it when you come back over this. I don't even know what it was. I had a laugh, and I enjoyed Triggered and Son losing his shit, roasting these two folks. So, you guys, thanks so much for hanging out with us. Make sure you follow Catalina Sofia on the social media. Subscribe if you haven't already. Hit that bell icon, all notifications, and vote this video up to let YouTube know you enjoyed what you watched. Also, make sure to follow Triggered and Son on his YouTube channel. I'm Jabby Kowei. This is
Catalina Sofia.
Peace out.